got into tea. Thanks to the team council, which agreed to, you know, get on to this particular topic of safe schools. And you saw right from adolescence how exactly we kind of moved around to finally come into a school segment as such. One of the major things which, you know, I've been trying to attend various conferences, summits, and trying to sit across in different forums, sometimes I think we really need to understand that there are a lot of things which we are doing very, very seasonal. I consider them as very, very seasonal. And most of the time, an incident happens, we take a reaction to it, we are not proactive to it, and most of the time, if we are proactive, probably that particular incident might have not happened. This is where the whole concept of safe school is very, very important, need to be understood, need to be appreciated from the perspective of school leadership team. And that's where, well, I have some inputs also for the council, because they go through the application process. Exactly right at that particular stage, it says if we can nip this particular problem, probably we don't have to do corrections thereafter. It is only the improvisation, it is only the thought process which we really need to look upon. So what is that? Before even getting, I have some pictures, I have some images which are downloaded from different sites, but the most important thing is any example given by me in this particular forum is purely coincidental. So don't go back and say, sir, you know, my school incident, no. Because after assessing over hundreds of institutions within India and outside, when it comes to general governance or school governance or school safety, what we found out was, it was very, very interesting that people at the leadership level never even knew what safety policies are about. I was quite surprised recently when in India, a couple of affiliating boards sent out a mail to schools, please send us your mission statement. Suddenly people realized that because Sars and we never had a vision, so we were running a school without a vision. We had a vision, but we had never put it into some commonly agreed vocabulary which was being appreciated by everybody in our system. If you're not going to do that in our own system, then every time there is a change in the leadership, the new person will bring in the new perspective. Whatever I am saying, you can go and check in your school diaries. Particularly the schools which are in residential schools, you can go and check in the hostel section. Every time there is an incident, one more item gets added, A, B, C, D, F. So 1971 to 72, F gets added, 1980, G get added. So we keep on adding without even understanding that there were a lot of things which were irrelevant before that. So this is where we really need to understand and start working on it. Ask this question to yourself, how safe is my school? We think everything is fine in my school. And the most interesting thing which I have seen in the schools is, thanks to the government regulation, you need cameras or safety, cameras to be there in every school. I am very happy about it. But my problem is the location of the TV in the principal's room. I am not worried about why it is being put in the principal's room. There is no correlation. Is the principal security chief of the school? Now don't tell me, sir, accused one invariably, legally, is the principal, whether you like it or not. Whether you like it or not. So I have a TV in my room. Excuse me. Your teacher is noticing which are the zones where you are not able to see. The child is more worried to see if madam kya check kar rahi hai, kaun kaun sa camera kaam kar raha hai, nahi kar raha. Third, which is the most important thing, after having this all this data, what is the shelf life for this data to be kept? That is what you are saying. If most of the cases take at least 9 to 10 weeks to get reported if it is physical abuse. When we don't have any data for it. And the first thing which the external body comes and asks you is your school attendance register. Second is the video tapes what you have made of that particular, you know, over that particular time. This is where we are contradicting many a times and we think that our school is safe. every time. Why this problem is? Let me show you some real-time images. Now, when we ask school how safe is, people give me answer like this. Because there is no correlation between the wants, the need, and reality. There is no correlation. I can tell you there is no correlation. And if I go into more details into this, then what happens, you know, they give me such information which I am not able to understand anything. Because we are collecting so much of data right from morning till evening, and we don't even use the data. In one particular school, it was very interesting when we were, you know, doing assessment. There is one particular primary parent who used to come and sit in the child's class. We were thinking that there is so much of interest in the child. It was not only interest on the child, it was interest on the teacher. I am not exaggerating, this is a live example from Punjab. Okay? Why I am giving you this example is, we have so much of data, we don't know who is coming, who is going. You, if you ask school leaders, go back to your school, don't tell anybody before you reach your school, ask for the security register. And see, 99% of the time, we have only written in time, out time. Even if it is written, people don't know why this person has spent. Ask your security head, please tell me, last 1 month, how many people have come and who have repeatedly come? Who have repeatedly come? And this is where we really need to understand. Every piece of data in our campus has a relevance. And if you're not collecting it, I think we are creating good volumes of material which is of no use to anybody. Going further from here, let's see some realities. This is covered in a higher education institution. I don't have a problem with the cupboard. I don't have a problem with the cupboard. I have a problem with the location of the cupboard. And what happens here? The most interesting thing is, I think, you know, when we conduct all the examination, all question papers comes in a plastic cover. Now see that cover there in the yellow one. That is the most worst part of it. I don't know what they do with the cover, but the cover will be attended to the attendant who will come to the attendant later. Who will tell you? Now this is where I am giving you the hard pictures. And today if government is becoming, asking us to become more compliant, we really need to understand how exactly it works. See, look at this. Why the government will not say, put a yellow color bus rakhna zaruri nahi hai. All the buses which are running on a highway for long routes, when they don't have any life, it gets colored, painted into yellow, and then there's a grill being put, and then, you know, air-conditioned buses, so-called, sorry. This is also happening. Look at this image. That's where we need a whole policy. Look at this image. Can you imagine what's happening here? It's also very clearly mentioned. Examination center. Kahan par ho raha hai? Dekha mindset humara. This is not Bihar. This is Maharashtra, Nanded. Okay, so this, see how much we have contrived thinking towards certain locations, and this is how we impact our thinking process. If we have to align, we really need to look at it. Look at this. When we try to talk about infrastructure, look at the teacher. These are all hard facts. Look at this particular image. Look at this, which is very, very recent. I think I had so many people. Because there was no teacher available for somebody to take care, you tie that person and make them to sit up. Very fresh. Now, where are we moving towards it? This is where there is a necessity which has been felt that education is not about transfer of knowledge, getting admission. This is what it means. The whole world is redefining, and I'm quite happy the council has taken a topic on happy child, happy classrooms. I'm quite happy about it because it is not about only the child scoring, it's all about active, good and happy citizens. And where is our role as school? We really need to understand that our role as school is to create those experiences. Dr. Jugal said a fantastic thing. He said, aap kuch bhi karo, if your environment is not safe, everything is waste. And that's where we really need to create experiences that lead to new competences, changes in attitudes for future behavior. We are not talking about today, we are talking about future behavior. Now, going further from here, see, I'm not here to give any yarn to anybody here. All of you are experts. You know your terrain better. But when you travel back from here, just reflect on some of the questions which I'm going to leave it with you. Because this is going to help you to understand where are we and what we still need to do. And the simple questions are, expectations of affiliate, I'll take them one by one. Because these are five or six simple things which we need to look at it. The first one is expectations of affiliating regulatory and statutory bodies. Tell me frankly, when we apply for affiliation, 5 certificate lekar submit kiya hoga, jaisa se tha 6. But every state has minimum more than 40 regulatory and statutory norms to be followed. How many of us in this audience are aware of it? Please, if you are good, I am happy about it. Just reflect. I don't want any answer from anyone. What I am asking is, please reflect. Because at the end of the day, school leadership team is key. If you don't have the awareness, what is that you are going to go and talk about? How many of us know that there is something called as National Building Code? And in National Building Code, there is a specific chapter for schools. And in schools, I'm sure, in affiliation process, we need to start from the compound wall. But we don't start from the compound wall. We start from the structure and then go to compound wall. Because your first aspect has to be from the compound wall. Otherwise, when the school has just started in the 2 years, you will have one day tiger coming in, like what happened in Bangalore. Someday you will have a lion coming into the school, and you will find that sports department, they have a very good engagement model. And this is where we really need to understand what is the height, what is the location, where exactly school needs to be there. See, this is where the regulatory is becoming much more stringent. Today, if you come to Bangalore, they will never allow you to do anything on a lake bed. Because on a lake bed or a river bed, the price of the land is less. But please understand, that land you may have to go 3 floors down, which will be higher cost to make the foundation than actually the structure. So while doing the investment, please start working. I understand. In school sector, there is always a problem between Mata Saraswati and Mata Lakshmi. Because we always try to balance, okay? If the Lakshmi is too good, then Saraswati has a problem. If Saraswati is too good, Lakshmi has a problem. So then how can we give quality education? How can we give quality education? And that's where you have a very important role of understanding what your affiliating, regulatory, statutory body is asking for. Once you have understood this, we need to have safe school policy. Now this is again fantastic. Ek page mein bhi policy hai, 20 page mein bhi policy hai school ke website pe. And kafi policies or most of the policies which are written in most of the websites or in schools are Ashwathama Diet. Ashwathama Diet. Because if it is favoring me, I will use it like this. If it is against me, I will. That's where we really need to know, reflect, do you have all this in your policy? Do we have a statement of purpose? Do we have a scope written, what it will cover? What are the objectives and strategies we are following this year for safety or whatever in our campus? Are we talking about processes? Do we have a supporting structure? Do we have measurable outcomes? The last one is very difficult. Communication to stakeholder. Don't give full information. If you give full information, we are in trouble. That's why government also said, in school management committee, put to parents. The problem is the SLCs don't happen. The minutes only goes home for signature in many of the cases. I'm giving you something very hard reality you may have to reflect. I'm not saying all schools are bad. I'm saying there are few schools because of which the regulator is becoming tougher and tougher, tougher and tougher. And that's where we really need to understand. The structure for execution. I'm sure, thanks to one Kumbhakonam incident, suddenly we had so much of love with that red color camp. Everywhere it was available. When we went for assessment of some schools and we asked them, can we talk about your safety? They said, all the fire extinguishers are kept in strategic locations of the school. I said, wow, kya English with that? I asked, where all you have kept? One at the security gate, which is half a kilometer away. One in the computer center, which is not accessible because it has a drill gate and two more gates. Third in the principal's room. Tell me all these three things are easily available for anybody. Then, how can it be strategically located? We really need to understand this. Because if you have a structure, we really need to understand. Please, 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 don't celebrate fire evacuation drills in your school as Shraddh, which we celebrate in our country annually once. Because there is no data for the Shraddh, but for your school, there is a data required. What was the last child's movement? What was the last child walking out? Do we have a practice? Ask. Think, reflect, it will help you. Communicate. Very difficult for us. We don't communicate to the parents. We don't communicate to somebody. Let me give you a simple example. This is such a big hotel. Where is the fire exit on this particular thing? God forsake, nothing should happen to anyone of them. Where is the fire exit on this particular block? Only one, right? There also. Good. My question is, organizers, in your school annual day, please have at least two slide presentation saying, kuch idhar hua, to kidhar jana. Kuch hua, to kidhar jana. And I'm not exaggerating. In Jharkhand, in one of the major sports day sports celebration of one of the corporates, they had put polythene sheet on the top. They had put polythene sheet on the top on a sports day to make sure it's a low cost. And fire takes over, the polythene melts, falls to me. And this is a lie. How many of us have heard of it? This is where our annual day with the Tabu Ratana, uske liye koi question hona zaroor hai. This is where we should have people. We should have people. Even on a terrorist attack happening at Mumbai, Taj Hotel, they first looked out for that manual safety exit kaapra batao. They never looked out ki Asha department ka hai and the other department. They only looked out safety manual. Where is the exact exit plan for that? That's where we really need to understand. And if you can understand that, please communicate. This is very difficult. This is very, very difficult in the school sector because most of the management meetings, if it is 1 hour meeting, 50 minutes goes only on academic results. We are only bothered about academic results. Can the management contribute in any way other than giving you the approval for doing some changes? We put it across them. We are doing this, we are doing this. They should not be bothered. My question is, next time when you have your management meeting, don't run it more than 5 slides. If you are running for more than 5 slides, that means we have a problem. And the worst is, now annual day season is coming. We will, in between the presentation, we will have a video connection nowadays, thanks to technology, which allows us to connect the video. And everybody says, aap mein aise, fantastic program. And the discussion goes on program, but management review doesn't happen. Please understand, in one particular school, we were able to get this data fantastic. When we saw that a lot of children were going from the primary years to the infirmary, we asked them to collect the segmented data. We found out that most of the children were going and complaining about stomachache. Then we said, stomachache to pani problem. We went and checked the quality of water, all right. Maintenance okay, everything okay. But most interesting thing which came out from a parent, not from the teachers, was, sir, mere bachche ne kaha hai, school mein जो मैडम है इंफर्मेरी में, वो हमें एक दवाई देती है, वो किसकी तरह है? हाजोला की तरह है। व्हाट इज दैट हाजोला? इट इज एन आयुर्वेदिक डॉक्टर गिविंग अ टैबलेट फॉर स्टमक एक। सो चिल्ड्रन गो टू इंफर्मेरी नॉट फॉर स्टमक एक बट टू गेट एट। This has not come up through any one of the researchers. Okay, it has not come through any. It has come up with sheer common sense and a proper review done by the management. And this is where we really need to understand. If the management is not to come, the management is the first and the foremost thing. How is this data management? I have given you input. If you don't have data, it is only storytelling. It's only storytelling. Reflect on your annual reports. When we present the annual reports, we say, ICAC we got this result. How many times we have said, we targeted for this and we got this. If you are doing it, please continue. Otherwise, go back and reflect. For us, it might be just one child. Imagine for the other side, the parent, that is the only child after many years the child has come. And they are 100% failure. So we really need to understand how to play with data and update. Don't celebrate anniversaries for policies. If there is an amendment given by the government, please incorporate at the earliest, well, before the next management meeting. अरे सर आप पॉलिसी की बात करते हैं, हमारे स्कूल में सर्कुलर एनिवर्सरी मना लेते हैं। यदि आपको सर्कुलर का एनिवर्सरी निकालना है तो एक छोटा सा प्रैक्टिस कीजिए। जब भी आप सर्कुलर पे साइन करते हैं तो नीचे लिख लीजिए डेट ऑफ रिमूवल। Date of removal. You want your teachers to work? Go to all the display boards and you stick on a post-it date of removal. And attender will come and remove on the date. And then you see your school will not only be clean, your notice boards will also start acting work for them. And that's something you really need to do. The way forward for all of you, kya karna aage? I think there are simple 3 B's. One B is when you walk back, look at your school. Because when you walk into the hotel, what did you look? You looked at the ambience, you looked at the layout, you looked at the seating arrangement, how exactly people are there, what kind of facilities are there, everything you were kind of looked at. Now this is a very interesting new corridor in a school. The children are running too much on the corridor. They have not done a hum. It is only the painting. It is only the painting which is being done, which psychologically puts pressure on the person to... Okay, you need to understand. This is not mine. This is not my. People have experimented with this. And I can show you, see, this is more a 20 minutes trailer session. Okay, we can talk a little later, but when you talk in 20 minutes, you need to give only sample taste. Right? So we really need to understand this is what safety is all about. How people are trying to talk about. How safe is your school self-explaining? Please move your 10, 9, 10, 11, 12 next to principal rooms. Most of the schools have this problem, more discipline problem. Keep it closer to principal's room. So she can just walk around them. Ground floor is only for primary years. Spend time. Otherwise, you'll find the primary children walking 2 floors and 3 floors, which is not right. So safety starts from the way you've done your place. If somebody walks into your institution, can they? What is the place till where they can go, where they should not go further? All of us have this blue color badge in our campus like this. Whenever you have an external vendor, try to get a multicolor badge and tell your children any vendor means this external person. And I was quite disturbed last time when I saw it in media and it was on WhatsApp group. Don't allow your student to talk to your non-teaching staff. Excuse me, we are in India. We have a culture of bhai and didi. We don't have a culture view external or any external service provider when he or she comes. Give a jacket, let him wear. Walk into your classroom to do the ready, the soft board or whatever the smart board or the LCD. But differentiate, educate, communicate. It will help you. And that's where the base. Second is people. When we do assessments of institutions, we found a very interesting thing in that. When we ask people, ki aisa kuch hai aapke school mein aapko maloom hai, Sir, we have a core committee which did this. We have a core committee which did this. So please understand, your people also, you know, are saying how safe is your school. Many a times when you walk with a lot of school principals and owners on the corridors, the body language of the people itself tells us what kind of culture exists in this particular. If there is too much of humbleness, that means you know the answer better than me. And it is also equally important, the people's mobility. Some examples were given by my friends in the panel, but what I would like you to say is that please see suddenly if a teacher has changed too many hands, if a teacher's behavior has not been so much, but suddenly there is a change in the behavior of the pattern, please make a note of it. Even if it is a teacher. Because why I am saying is that when money comes, certain things aspects come in, there are people who are also getting diverted because they know how to spend, where to spend. And that's where it is equally important that the people have to be oriented repeatedly every year. And even in every 2 days, you know, in the starting of the academic year, we celebrate something called as orientation program. On that day, please spend half an hour, 1 hour, what is certain policies of our school. Because when they go out to the parent, they should speak the same language what you want them to speak. What you want them to speak. Otherwise, it will become like a TV show where nobody knows what's happening. And finally, practices. We don't map practices. Jab jab principal gaye, tab tab practices bhi unke saath chalenge. Because we have not ingrained them as routines in our campus. If we have ingrained them as part of our routines, we will never have a problem. And that's where each one of us sitting in this room has a role to ensure that every child who is in our institution, we need to work on it. How can we do this? Many panelists have said, I also say, raise awareness. Bring in internal capability. My suggestion, there are many service providers here, but I have a very simple question. Any service provider spending more than 18 months in your campus and you're not being able to internalize, I think you have failed as a leader. Because in 18 months, it has to get ingrained into your system. You may take the hardware part of it, but software has to become a routine. We have so many good friends here. How many of us did bother to ask others, good morning, ma'am, did you brush in the morning? We never ask anyone of us. We know that's a part of our culture. We are all, literate. And when we are literate, these things are expected. So in the same way, our practices also need to work on your people. Invest on your people. Let the principals, teachers go to other schools. I'm okay. Many times, people don't even send for workshops for, teachers. Jo jayega, wo office nahin aayega. Kyunki na, har program mein likha rehta hai, TN networking. So networking is the most, same thing is with very principals also. Many management, if there are management, please invest. Even if you have been able to produce 100 principals for the, wherever city you are, please create one roll of honor in your school. How many principals did you produce? Please invest. You take a credit saying that Aziz is a school ke principal, mere school mein guru hai. And that's what is going to be important. And finally, change. Don't be reactive. I think I have a very, professor here. He will shortly agree. All of us know about an incident happened in, Delhi a few years ago, and then the mobiles got banned. But Vimhans did a study based on that. How many of us are aware of it? Go back and do a little research on it. You'll be able to appreciate that the problem was not about the mobile. It was all about the practices of the school. And if that is there, we can start working on it. But I believe, including me, all of us in this room have a role to play. We cannot make schools safe alone, and we really need to invest. Because what we believe is, every child safe, it is my duty, it is my right. You need to ensure that how you will give that safe environment, which I will choose the way I want to learn. Because philosophically, it has been always said that no school teaches a child. It only creates an environment where the child will decide how he or she wants to learn. With that note, thanks once again to the leadership team out here for the opportunity and for the conversation.